Honorable Chief Guest of today's function, Sri C.H. Mallareddy Sir, Minister of Telangana, and Honorable Chairman of St. Martin Engineering College, Sri Lakshman Reddy Sir, Executive Director, G. Chandrasekhar Yadav Sir, Director, J. Kishan Yadav Sir, on stage, SMIBM Principal, Dr. Dolly Diana, HODs, Deans, staff member, last but not the least, the first year students and their parents, a very good morning to all of you. So, first of all, I would like to congratulate all the students, those who have got a chance to study in this 17 years of excellent engineering college in Twin City of Telangana. So, can we have a big round of applause for our first step of success? And I would like to mention here, so St. Martin Engineering College, which runs under St. Martin Children's Education Society, which was started in the year of 1982 by four philanthropists. First is C.H. Mallareddy Sir, Honorable Minister, then our Chairman Lakshman Reddy Sir, then Durga Yadav Sir and Narasimha Yadav Sir, both are businessmen. So these four philanthropists, they have decided to start the trust, and they started one school, and there are three schools running under the trust and one engineering college. In the year of 2002, St. Martin Engineering College was established. So this is the only college where we have NAC A plus accreditations, and all the departments are accredited by NBA. And recently we have completed all the formalities to get the autonomous. Soon, with God's grace, we will be autonomous. So one more round of congratulations to all of you for all these laurels and to be a part of this great history creating institution. So today is the orientation day. There might be a lot of dream in students' mind, and there might be a lot of aspiration, dreams, goals in the parents' mind too. Okay, so I am going to divide my talk in two parts, one for the students and another for the parents. So parents, be relaxed completely. This is a 100% revving free campus. You need not have to bother, we will take care. Okay, so there are something which we need to look into very critically. So first I will start my talk towards the student, and at last I will come back to the parents. So student, please raise your hands. You have taken admission here. Have you set your goal? What you want to become? So those who have set your goals, please raise your hands. Rise properly. Very good. I will say great, impressive. Okay. So you have set your goals, right? What kind of goals you have set? What kind of goals you have set? So are you looking for a job opportunity, or you wanted to start your own company, or you wanted to go for the higher studies, or you might be taking care of your parental business? These are all some of the major selection what we have noticed from the student community. If you have set your goal, okay, that is fine, appreciable. But the thing is, goal should be more clear, and it should lead to your destiny. For an example, have you visited the college completely, all of you? Okay, so we have put some placement banners and the achievements of all the placed achievers. Okay, so also we have listed out the companies where our students and your seniors have been placed. Okay, you would have seen the list of those companies. Have you selected that in which company you wanted to join and you wanted to work for those companies? Have you selected in your mind? That has to be done. First, setting the goal is more important in your career. You have to decide You wanted to work for Adobe, you want to work for Microsoft, you want to work for IBI, you want to work for Infosys, or you want to work for Microsoft, or you want to work for Mindtree. So this goal need to be set fast. If you set your goal, then for each company, the paths are different. Up to some extent, you will walk in a common path, then there will be a dedicated path you have to walk on yourself, so that you will reach to your destiny. So, just like that, by setting the goal itself, you will not reach to the destiny. There are something else also we need to do. What is that? We have to add a right fuel in our mind. This mind is what? It is like a machine. And how the machine runs? How the machine runs? How the vehicle runs? You have to give petrol or diesel. And nowadays more popular CNG. So that is also a fuel, right? Okay, you have to add the right fuel. For an example, I have seen lot of villages are there, and if you go to any barber shop, we go for hair cutting and all, right? Okay. That barber, we expect him to be good in what? We expect him to be good in hair cutting, right? Okay. But that knowledge he will have 2%. Remaining the entire world knowledge, he will have 98%. Who will get tickets for MLA? Who will be the next MP? Who will be the next Prime Minister? What is happening at Japan? All these things, the 98% information he will be having in his mind, and 2% he will have knowledge on hair cutting. What is his profession? He is a barber, right? Okay. What he is expected to improve his skill? He should be having good knowledge on different types of styles of haircuts and how the hair can be taken care. We expect him to groom his skill in that. But keeping that aside, he improves his skills on all unwanted things. And finally, what happens? The customers which are all coming, and there will be a drop down, and finally one day there will not be any customer. And that fellow keep on blaming that, my luck is not good. You fellow, your luck is not good or bad. You have not added the right fuel in your mind. All unwanted things you have dumped in your mind. You are expected to improve the skill in one area, you are totally distracted and you are moving in another way. So same thing happens to the student mind also. Now there is a lot of distractions. Facebook is there, WhatsApp is there, lot of social media, like internet in everybody's hand, lot of distractions are there. So we need to understand all these unwanted things need to be kept in mind, or we need to add the right fuel which will drive you to reach your destiny. You need to decide. See, everybody has got some jewelries and properties, right? Either little or middle or maybe more. Okay, everybody has got some gold jewelry and everybody has got some money. Yes or no? Yes or no? It is there. Okay, if anybody comes to your home, maybe friend or guest or whoever, are you allowing them to take away all of your monies and jewelries? You don't give, right? You don't give. Nobody gives, right? Okay. Similarly, your mind is also like that. Don't allow anybody to get into your mind and disturb. Don't allow anybody to extract all these good informations what is there in your mind. You should be a sole controller of your mind, and you should be a owner of your mind. Nowadays, from the present generation, we are seeing that it is all missing. So I advise all of the students, don't get distracted, set your goal, add right fuel into the mind, so that it will lead to reach your right destiny. Then second thing is, see, everybody comes for studies here. You would have seen some of the photos where the students are offered, same students who are all sitting like this in the same room before 5 years. They have been placed in Adobe with 26 lakhs per annum. They have been placed in Microsoft, IBI, Byju's, 10 lakhs and above per annum. And you could also see, we have put the poster outside, some of the students, they have placed in some of the companies where the pay packages are 4 to 5 lakh rupees. Same student, same teacher, same college, same class, but there is a variation. Why this variation came? Because it is purely the viewpoint of the student. I will just narrate you a small story. You will understand what is the concept of viewpoint and how we should discharge our duty very honestly and dedicatedly. See, one person was walking on the road and he saw that, okay, so three people are standing and they were breaking the stones. That one big stone was there and they were breaking through hammer and they were making it small, small chips, which is all used for the house construction works. You would have seen, they break the big stones and they make it as metal pieces. That work was going on. Then this gentleman who was crossing them, he asked the first person, what are you doing here? By hearing this question itself, that first fellow was so irritated and he responded in a very rude way and he said that, can't you see, I am breaking the stone and making it small chips. This is the answer from the first person. Okay, how many persons were there? Three were there. Okay, then this gentleman went to the second person. He asked, what are you doing? Then the second person answered, this is what my lifestyle and the profession. I have to break this stone, then only I will get some money. I can feed myself and I can feed to my family. It is my daily food. This is the second person answered. Then he went to the third person. What are you doing? Question is remain same. Then the third person told, here there is a plan of building a big temple and it's my honor that I am going to be a part of that great creation. And my hard work is going to be contributed for the creation of the temple. Same work, right? Same work. See, the three different viewpoints are there for the work. So that is why it is more important how you look at your studies and how you focused on your goal. One is what? One viewpoint could be, exams are there, to pass the exam I am studying. Second thing is what? Teachers are scolding, HODs are behind me, parents are looking at me, I have to clear, somehow I have to complete my engineering. That is the second way of studying. Third thing is what? I will uplift the reputation of my family. I will take my family to the next level. That is why I am studying. So, the viewpoint will change your lifestyle. And this 4 years, if you are dedicated and you are devotional towards your studies, it will change your life and it will change the generation of you also. And we are seeing, there are many number of success stories I can just like that narrate, where you will see that the students have reached to the pinnacle of success by contributing all the 4 years for their studies. So I wish that you should focus on that area and you should not be deviated and you should do your work very hard. Now I will come to the second part, okay, about the responsibility and about the engineering subjects and all. Okay, so how many of you, your elder brother or sister or relatives are already engineers and you are in touch with them? Please raise your hands in your family. Very good. Okay. So what is the feedback they have given about the engineering? Whether engineering is an easy course or a difficult course? What they have told you? Easy? Difficult? Moderate? Or it depends? I will tell you. I will tell you how the engineering subjects are and how your work and how your focus towards the engineering. Engineering degree is a 4 years degree course, right? Okay. I will tell you in the form of a small story, then I will take two minutes to address to the parents, then I will sign out and I will be eagerly waiting to listen to our honorable minister also. Thank you, sir. So, see, one day what happened? One person, he was from village. It is just a story. I am not touching to the subject. Don't worry. Subject will start from tomorrow. Okay. So, this is just a story. Okay. Just to make you understand what is engineering and how you could be successful. Okay. So, one person was from village. He was from a village origin. And he had gone to a city and he was working. Many people you would have seen. They come out from the village and they were working in different places. Okay. What was his profession? He was a sculptor. Means who do the work on the stone items. They take the stones and they create, they give different shapes to the stones. Right. He was doing that. So one day he decided after 10 years to go back to the village and spend some time in the village. Okay. So, and his physical location, the geographical location of his village is what? Okay, it is, he has to board a bus, he has to travel 200 km and he has to get down, and he from that bus stop, he has to walk for 5 km. Right? Is it clear? Then he will reach to his village. So he had boarded the bus, he has traveled, he has got down, and then he started walking. Because he has to walk 5 km, then only he will able to reach to his village. So while walking, he was tired, and after walking for 2 km, he sat on a tree. Then he could able to see one nice stone is lying beside the tree. And as he just cultured, and he was having a bag, so he took the hammer and the chisel from the bag, and he picked that stone, and he started to hit to that stone. Because he just cultured, he wanted to give a proper shape to the stone. The moment he wanted to give the hit, immediately that was a special stone, and that stone started speaking. And that stone told that one, no, no, don't give me any pain, don't disturb me, and don't hammer me on me, I will not able to tolerate your pain. This is the answer he received from the stone. He was totally surprised and a bit disappointed also. Then he left that place and he started walking to its village. Then on the way, again he saw another tree and he was little tired also. He thought, okay, let me sit down and take little rest here. Then again this story repeats here. He could able to see a stone which is lying down beside the tree. He picked that stone and took out his chisel and hammer and started giving the strokes. And by giving lot of strokes, he could able to make a beautiful Lord Ganesha's idea from the stone, right? And he was so happy, and he kept that God's ideal below the tree, and he started and he reached his hometown, the village. The moment he reached, he could able to see that lot of people are gathered, new constructions have taken place, because after 10 years he is visiting the village. And people are roaming here and there, rushing, lot of discussions are going on. Then he caught hold of one person and asked, what is that it is happening? Then the gentleman asked, oh, you don't know, because you are there in the city for 10 years, we have constructed a very big, beautiful temple, and we are planning, and tomorrow is the inauguration of the temple. Chief guests and all have decided they are coming. The only issue is what? We do not have ideal till now. So we are planning to go to city immediately, purchase a Lord Ganesha's ideal, and we wanted to come back. Okay, that is what we are deciding, how to go and get it done fastly. Then this person answered, I have solved your problem. You just walk for 2 km, you will see that one, okay, one Ganesha ideal while coming on the way, I have created and I have kept it. You please go and get it there. Then people, village people were so happy, okay, their problem is solved. Okay, then there was a need of a stone where in front of Ganesha that will be kept to breaking the coconut. Okay, then this person again told that, again walk further 2 km, you will see a tree and beside that there is a stone, you pick that stone. So the village people followed his instruction, they went and they picked the ideal Ganesha and they bought that stone also. So the Ganesha was kept for worship and that stone was kept in front of the Ganesha to break the coconut. Okay, so every day the lot of devotees were coming and they were bringing the coconut, they were breaking the coconut and they were going to Lord Ganesha and worshipping and coming back. This story was continuing for few days. After that, the stone which was kept to break the coconut, that fellow is asking to Lord Ganesha's stone. Okay, see my fact is, who are all visiting, they were giving a pain to me by breaking the coconut here, and all are going to you, they were bowing their head and they were worshipping you. Why there is a difference? Why there is a difference? Then that Lord Ganesha's stone ideal is responding, the first stroke which was given to you, if you would have tolerated that pain, you would have been worshipped today. As you did not come out from your comfort zone, throughout your lifetime, this pain you have to bear. That is what the engineering is. Why I am narrating this story? That is what the engineering is. Lot of pain will be there. lot of sacrifices you have to do. You will not be allowed to go and attend your relatives' marriage and functions and all, because you will have exams. This pain will be there in the mind and heart. You have to tolerate. You have to tolerate. These 4 years, if you give it to you, your entire life will be on your footstep. Else, you remember the story of these two stones. One is Ganesha, another one is kept for breaking the coconuts. Okay. So, my dear students, okay, engineering is very simple if you take it in that way. Else, it is very tough if you take it in other way. Okay, it will change your life. It is a life-changing course. Okay, so then I will come to the parents and their responsibility, because every day we meet with the parents and we interact with them. How many of the parents you feel that, okay, so their 10th and plus 2 is over from reputed schools and colleges. Now they got a MCAT rank or whatever it is through management or whatever it is, they got a admission in engineering. Okay, our responsibilities are over. How many of you feel like this? Please raise your hand. Yeah. Yes. Okay. So I think very few people, they think that one, no, okay, their responsibilities are over. Okay. So, but majority, I am very happy and I am delighted that, okay, you feel that your responsibilities are there. I truly agree with you, your responsibilities are there. And how critical responsibilities are there. Complete hand-holding is required. This is the critical age. Lot of hormonal changes happens at this age. You should not allow your wards, no, to move independently and take their own decision. Or you should not think that, okay, they were grown enough to take their own decision. That is the biggest mistake what the many parents they think. You are busy. I respect to your profession. I respect to your timings and all. You are busy. But it is your own child. Responsibilities are also there. Every semester, 2 times we will call for parents meeting. Please come and attend. Please come and attend. We will narrate you everything about your students, about your words, plus, minus, where it requires improvement and all. For every 20 students, we allot a mentor. Every 1.5 months, there will be a test. And the progress report and the marks and the achievements of the student, everything will be shared with the parents. So I request all the parents, don't think that the path of success or the journey of success is ended once I put my son or daughter in the engineering college. The real critical time starts now. And we are seeing the parents which are all connected. See, the success cycle is, it is a 3 iteration. One is what, student, teachers, and the third one is the parents. It is a cycle. It is a cycle. And the students are spending 8 hours with us. Remaining 16 hours, they are with the parents. So how we discharge our responsibility? We seek the parents' cooperation also in each and every step of your world success. And we have seen, whenever the parents have connected and they are interacted and they have visited the college, they have spoken to the teachers and all, we are seeing that how their children are shining in their career. So that is why my request and appeal to all the parents to be a part of this 4 years journey. We don't want to disturb you, but at least take out 2 days in a semester and don't forget to visit the college so that you will come to know what is what. And the last 2 important points. Many parents, they have come and they have asked me, sir, what will be the dress code? Okay, because we have seen in movies, right? Okay, college is something different. Okay, it's not like that. It's not like that. Okay, boys and girls, formal dress code only, it is all permitted. Okay, it, still you are a student, and parents, I request also, all the companies will be visiting. Today also, one more company's recruitment drive is going on in our campus. Okay, they expect the students to be formal and they should be presentable to the society. Society in the sense, in front of everybody. That should be the dress code. So I don't want to debate on that, but I think I made my point very clear, what should be the dress code. Then the last and foremost important point is, okay, you would have seen in the movie that students are coming to the college, they spend time in canteen, gossiping and all these things, they don't attend the classes and all. please wipe out all these thoughts. Here it is not going to happen in that way. 100% you have to be in the class. You have to attend the classes. 75% mandatory requirement to appear for the university examination, else you will be detained. You will not get a chance to sit for examination. And another beauty is, I will advise to all the students and the parents, don't send them for any kind of tuitions. Don't listen to all these fellows. It's not required. It's not required. Our teaching learning process is so effective. If the student comes regularly, I can give you the guarantee that he will pass with very good percentages. So that is why the primary objective of the parents and students should be, every day you must come and attend. And beyond academics, we have many number of clubs. Then we have programmings, we have soft skill training program, just to groom them and make them ready for the industry from day one itself. So these are all things what I thought I must share with you. Again, a big congratulations to all the students, those who got a chance to be a part of this excellent institution who has created the history for last 17 years. You might be knowing this is the only college which is accredited with NAC A plus grade. All departments are accredited by NBA. There are 25 books have been published by our own faculty. 700 and more research papers are published by our own